I will test this faulty Embraco compressor inverter board with a multimeter and with an oscilloscope and try to fix it. I will check where the fault is in this circuit board. You can see the model number written on this circuit board. I already have repaired one of this circuit board in my previous video. This is the second board I am gonna try to repair. I will now power on this circuit. It is faulty, so that's why I didn't attach the compressor with it. 14.24 volts are shown on capacitor number 8, which is fine. 17.82 volts are shown on capacitor number 9, which is fine too. 2.6 volts are passing through the capacitor number 11. This capacitor should have 5 volts passing through it. But they are less than 5 volts. No volts are passing through the capacitor number 511, which means that this circuit has a problem with it. Now these capacitors for the U, V, and W terminals which are attached to the compressor drivers. I will check these capacitors. Not the required voltages on this capacitor. Now the next capacitor. The multimeter is not showing the required voltages on the second capacitor either. No voltages on the third capacitor. Only 6 volts are shown, which is too low. I will now test this circuit board with the oscilloscope. I have attached one of the probes with the ground pin in the circuit. The signals are disturbed on the capacitor number 8. But the voltages were fine. Now let's check the capacitor number 9. The voltages on the multimeter were fine. The signals on this capacitor are fluctuating. The capacitor number 11 has a lot of spikes and disturbances in its waveform. The voltages are also low on this capacitor, 5 volts should have been passing across it. The capacitor 511 also has a lot of fluctuation. Now I will test the capacitor number 201. This capacitor was not showing voltages on the multimeter. But on the oscilloscope, it is showing voltages absolutely fine. This is the difference while checking with an oscilloscope. On the multimeter, it was showing 6 volts and on the oscilloscope, 15.4 volts are shown. Which are fine. And it has no spikes in its signals. Analyzing where the problem is in this circuit, is getting easier for me. The voltages on the next capacitor are also fine because if the voltages on the first capacitor are fine, the rest of them will also be good. This capacitor is also fine. I will check the third capacitor as well for my consolation. The signals on this capacitor are also stable. 15.6 volts are passing through this capacitor. This means the problem is around the microcontroller. In this circuit, the fault is not on the high side. The resistor and the diode in this circuit are fine. The 3 and 5 volt capacitor has disturbance. If you watch my videos, I always tell you that a physical test to fix any circuit board is really important. I tested this circuit board's physical condition. I found that no feedback is passing through the microcontroller. The voltages are disturbed on these two capacitors. The rest of the voltages like 15 and 18 volts on these capacitors are fine. The communication circuit of this inverter board has been badly damaged. The short circuit is here. DZ1 is written here, which is Zener diode number 1, it has been completely damaged. A resistor 403 is mounted here, it is also damaged. The resistor 401 is also damaged. I will replace all these three components. And we'll check the voltages of this circuit, and if it works then I will show it to you on the compressor. So I have changed the components in this circuit board. I have changed these capacitors. Other than this optocoupler. The Zener diodes. But the circuit board is behaving differently now. This circuit board is a good one. I will do a comparison between both of them, to show you what the fault is in the circuit board where I had installed new components. Because you won't understand it normally. But comparing both these circuits will make you understand it. I have installed the ground pins on both circuits. I will check its communication circuit because its communication circuit was short-circuited. So I am passing electricity through both circuits. It has been powered on. Now, you will have to see the oscilloscope carefully. I have placed the probes on both the optocouplers. The waveform is shown for both circuits. The blue-colored waveform is of a good circuit. The yellow-colored waveform is for the bad circuit board. The waveform of the bad circuit board is not generating. 1.4 volts are passing through the good circuit board. And 1.4 volts are also passing through the bad circuit as well. The voltages are fine. But the waveform on the bad circuit board is not generating. Now I am placing the probes on Zener diode number 1. The voltages should be the same on this Zener diode. No waveform is made here on the bad circuit board. I have placed the probes on capacitor number 401. The good circuit board capacitor generates the waveform, and the bad one does not generate signals. The problem with the circuit board is its microcontroller because it had a bad short circuit. Due to this, the microcontroller is short-circuited. The voltages in the circuit have been fixed. But we can't fix the short in the microcontroller. This circuit board is useless, but its other components can be used. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos. And subscribe. Thank you.